I was at a thrift shop when I saw this. There's no model number, but I think it's a Walter Products 3000F. And when I saw this, the first thought that came to my mind was, I wonder if I could attach a camera to this. And if I can, I wonder if I could scan my film with it. The short answer, yes, with an asterisk. This image came out to be 47,000 by 32,000 pixels, or 1.5 gigapixels. There was a number of issues I encountered. The first thing I needed was a way to attach a camera to the microscope. And from what I could tell, there are two options I could go with. One is a dedicated microscope camera, or two is an adapter to mount a DSLR onto it. I decided on the latter and I picked up this Amscope adapter. It wasn't cheap, but it was the cheapest option available. The next problem I ran into was regarding film flatness. It turns out microscopes have a very narrow depth of field, so if the film isn't perfectly flat across the stage, things will fall out of focus very quickly, which is why when you use a microscope, you put things on a glass slide. So I took a piece of glass and I wet mounted this single frame onto it. I've never wet mounted film before, so I really don't know what I'm doing. And unsurprisingly, I ended up with a lot of imperfections, like bubbles, wet spots, dust, etc. I'm pretty sure if I actually put some effort into it, I could eliminate most of these issues, but as of right now, I don't care. All I really care about is the film is now flat. When I took some photos, I immediately saw another problem. The edges and the corners were unusable. The corners capture beyond the image circle, so you have these black corners, and outside on the edges, the sharpness falls off quickly. While I'm not sure, I think the problem is this adapter. There are glass elements inside of it, so I wouldn't be surprised if they're not the highest quality and might be the culprit, or maybe something with the microscope, I don't know. Anyway, while it's not ideal, there is a workaround, and it's just crop the image. It sucks because in order to get the sharp parts, you only could really retain the center, which leads to the next problem. How do I consistently capture sections of the film? As an example, it takes about 25 photos to capture the film lengthwise, and I would need to move the film side to side in consistent increments. Fortunately, there is a solution, and I'm pretty sure some of you microscope nerds already saw it, but I bought a mechanical stage. It's this thing right here. It gives me precise XY movement controls of the slide. So with this, I now have consistent, repeatable, and measurable movements. After capturing all the images, Photoshop did most of the legwork. There were a few sections where it didn't know what to do and I had to manually align them, but I think that's a fair trade-off because in the end we're talking about almost 500 total images stitched together. This was built up layer by layer, and the final image kind of shows it. You could see this banding where the layers were stitched together, and I didn't crop the individual images enough, so there are spots where the sharpness just takes a dump. At a certain point, I knew this wasn't going to be perfect, so in my mind, this became less about a perfect scan and more just about sheer resolution and resolving power. And by the way, this was captured using the widest objective. I initially wanted to use like the medium objective, but that was taking too long. As a taste, here's an image I stitched together using the middle objective. This is just the number on the rebate. While this did give better results, it just took too long. I didn't even bother with the last objective. I'm already so far out of my wheelhouse, I'd figure I'd just stick to an easier path. One thing I forgot to mention is I captured all these images using my old Canon 5D Mark III, but in order to keep it true to the analog process, I captured all these images using this Kodak SD card, and then I stored all the images onto this Kodak SSD. While I had this camera out, I wondered if I could compare the microscope scan to, let's say, a regular DSLR scan. This is a Nikon 55mm f2.8 macro AIS with a PK13 extension tube. I'm not a big DSLR scan person myself, so I don't really have a whole lot of practice. I know there's a lot to be desired with this scan. For one, it's not perfectly level, so the top of the frame is out of focus. But this isn't about my ability to get a perfectly level scan, it's about comparing the resolution and resolving power. After cropping, this gets a respectable 5300 by 3600 pixel scan for a 19 megapixel image. And at 100%, this is what the image looks like. Compared to the microscope scan, there is no comparison when you look at the sheer resolution or resolving power, but looking at the full picture, the DSLR scan holds up a lot better. This was a little fiddly to set up, and I'm sure I'm not using the most optimal gear, but that's because I'm more of a standalone scanner person myself. This is my Nikon Super Coolscan 4000, which is my preferred way of scanning 35mm. This was able to get an image that looks like this. This is a 5500 by 3700 pixel scan for a 20 megapixel image, and at 100% it looks like this. Compared to the microscope scan, there is no comparison when you look at the sheer resolution or resolving power, but it's convenient, it's fast, and it gives sharp enough results. Speaking of sharp enough, I also have an Epson V850. According to Epson, the optical resolution when scanning film is 6400 dpi. Some people question the claim. I don't care. I use this scanner to just get good enough scans, not really for critical sharpness. This image is a 8900 by 5800 pixel scan for a 52 megapixel image. At a glance, the scans look alright, but when you zoom in at 100%, it gets mushy soft. Compared to the microscope scan, there is no comparison when you look at the sheer resolution or resolving power, but for general purpose viewing and sharing online, this is not bad at all. But if you like to zoom in and peep at them pixels, not that great. It's slower, it's softer, and there are better options out there. This is not one of them. This is a Sony Mavica FD5. This was introduced in 1997, and it stores photos onto the physical manifestation of the save icon. While I wasn't able to fill the entire frame, I got kinda close, and it got me an image that is 413 by 271 pixels for a whopping 111 kilopixels. And at 100%, it's tiny. Compared to the microscope scan, there is no comparison when you look at the sheer resolution or resolving power, but it was a valiant effort by this old camera, but probably not a fair comparison, so let's try something that was released a little more recently. That was about 1998 with the Game Boy camera, and this is what we got. I know there are 3D printed lens adapters for this, but I don't have one of those, so instead we're just shooting it raw. This image is 128 by 112 pixels for a 14 kilopixel image. At 100%, it's tiny. Compared to the microscope scan, there's no comparison when you look at the sheer resolution or the resolving power, but this also isn't the first time I shared this image with you. Remember this? If you look over here, hidden amongst the grain, yeah. So to wrap it all up, is it possible to scan film with a microscope? I'd say yes, but you would have to put in a lot of work to get a good photo, and it's more effort than I'm willing to put in right now. Initially, I wanted to see if I could do medium format, but one issue is the stage just doesn't have enough depth to scan one full 6x6 frame unless I cut the film in half, which I don't want to do. But instead of going bigger, now I'm curious if I could find smaller negatives. I've never had a desire to shoot 110 before, but now I kind of want to try. So there's a lot more work that could be done with this.